Hi, in this section we will see the seller's table, buyer's table, reserves table creations, and we will work on the queries related to the seller's, buyer's, reserves table. So here I am giving the three different tables. Seller's table. Seller's table contains four different fields: seller ID, seller name, seller rating, seller age. Okay, here you can identify that seller ID is taken as a primary key, and the data type for the seller ID we have taken as an integer format of data, and the seller name is a string format of data. In SQL, we can consider the string format of data is using a varchar format as well as a character format also. And rating is a integer format, and age is to be considered as a floating point numbers. Here I'm considering as a real format of data. The second table is boat table. Boat table contains three different fields: boat ID, boat name, boat color. Boat ID is taken as a primary key, and as well as it is integer data type data. Boat name is a string type data. So that is nothing but a name of the boat you are mentioning, and the colors also a string format of data. So that is nothing but either you can use that character format of data, char data type, or varchar data type, or varchar 2 data type. And the third one is the last table, or the third table is nothing but resource table. Resource table contains three different fields: SID, BID, and the day. So here the primary key is a combination of seller ID, boat ID, and the day. All these three attributes we have framed the primary key. And moving towards the foreign key references, the seller ID is taken as a primary key in the seller's table, but in the reserves table, seller ID is working as a referencing to the foreign key. It will work as a foreign key and referencing from the seller's table. Like that, boat ID is working as a foreign key in the reserves table, that is referencing from the boat table BAD primary key. So now we will see all the values of seller's table, boat's table, resource table. Now we will insert all these values into the SQL, into the database, structured query language that we are using. After that, we will work on some sample queries. Okay. So here I am explaining, I am informing you all also. Already I have created all the syntax and the semantics. Instead of wasting the writing that typing that all the queries and all the syntax and the semantics, I have already collected all the information and I already typed the information, so that I am projecting to you. So here you can see that the table creations of seller's table. So here you can see the seller's table creation: create table, table name. The seller ID is taken as a number format of data. Seller name is a varchar data type of 10 characters I am taking. Rating is a number format of data, only two digits of rating that you can identify, and age is a four digit format, and two digits are especially given for the fractional part. So like that, seller's table, to maintain the constraints for the table, primary constraint, alter the table, table name, add constraints, constraint name. Here peak underscore seller is a user defined constraint name, and the constraint type is a primary key. You are maintaining a primary key for SID. So after the table creation, we are retrieving the table descriptions. Either you can use the describe or DESC table name. So like that, same as boat table also created, and maintaining the boat table primary key, maintaining a boat table as a primary key, and like that same resource table, and maintaining the resource table primary key is a combination of seller ID, boat ID, day of reservation. After that, adding a constraints, foreign key constraints from to the resource table. So to add a constraints to the resource table, alter table, table name, add constraint. What type of constraint that you are adding? Foreign key. First, you have to be defined that, you have to be mentioned that user defined constraint name. FK stands for foreign key, FK underscore table name. For easy understanding, here I'm taking as like that. FK underscore resource is a user defined constraint name, and constraint type is a foreign key. Foreign key of SID referencing to the which table? Seller's table SID. So like that, SID taken as a foreign key, and resource table BID is also taken as a foreign key referencing from the boat's table BID. So after that, both seller boat's table and then as well as the resource table, both the table description that we have whether the constraint is maintained or not. So like that, we cross check. So after that, to insert any record into the table, we have to use the syntaxes insert into table name values and provide all the values of its tables according to the whatever the values have given. Here the first record I have given is a 22, distance 7, rating of age rating 7, and age of 45. So here you can see that insert into seller's name values 22, destiny is a seller name. Character, whenever the character format of data is occurred, you have to be represented within the single quotes, as well as the date is also within the representing single quote. And date, after that, rating we mentioned, and then age we mentioned. So like that, all the sales records have written that queries. All the insertion queries I have already written. So after that, I am using that commit. So when once we use the commit, means that is permanently recorded, permanently saved in the database. So retrieve the table values. To retrieve any table values from the table name, we have to use that select start from table names. Okay, like that, sales table is created. Now we move on to the boats table. Boats table is boat ID, boat name, and then color. All the boat related, all the four insertion that I have done, and retrieving the table values of boats table. So like that, same insertion values of a resource table also. So now the resource table values also I have inserted. So all these values, seller ID, boat ID, and the day of reservation, what we have done, and retrieving the table values of resource table. Now we will see all these tables into the Oracle extensible version, and we can crop. Once we inserting these values, so now we will work on the some sample queries. So now I connect to the database. Presently, what are the tables available in the table in this database login, that we will check. Select star from tab tells about the total tables that is created in this login. So presently we don't have any tables. So now we can create all these tables. Okay, already I have written all these indexes. I'm once again repeating. So just run these all these queries, whatever the syntaxes that I have written. So just run the all these queries. So for that, just simply copy, select copy, and move to the SQL, and then paste all the queries whatever I have. So whatever I have written, all are worked. So all are created. So once again cross check it. So here in the starting we have created, cross check that we don't have any tables. Now we created a table, and we maintain the table with a primary key. After the table description that we cross check like that, boats table we cross check. We maintain the boat table as a primary key, as well as the resource table we created, maintaining a primary key, maintaining a foreign key. So like that, boats table resource table, boats table already we created, and description about the both the tables, and inserting values to the boats table, and as well as the sales table, boats table, resource table, that we have done. Okay, so now in my database, how many tables that we have? Three tables. Select star from tab. So only three tables that we have. Okay, so now we will move on to the one by one query. So the first query related to the sales table. So here the question and answer both I have already written. So one by one we can cross check it. Find the names and ages of all the sellers. So already the query to print the name and age of all the sellers is select. You have to be used that to retrieve any record from the table name. You have to be used that select query. Select S name comma age. So select table contains of fields are the sellers name, S name, and then age field is age. Select S name comma age from sellers. Okay, so like that we can retrieve the table values. So otherwise cross check it. Here already I have taken as a query. Here I am displaying that whose ratings with the rating 10. Suppose if the question is select the print up, find all the names of sellers and ages of all the sellers whose rating is exactly 10. In such a case you have to be apply the where clause. Actually no need of this where clause. Even the to represent a particular condition, here I am representing like that. Okay, so only this part of query that is sufficient. So simply select S name comma age from sellers. So that means that you are printing that select sellers name and ages, all the sellers name and their ages. So move on to the next one. Find the all the sellers with the rating above 7. So in this query you can identify the relational operators with the rating above 7, exactly 7, at least 7. So like that. So that means that whose rating is greater than or equal, equal or not equal. So like that we can identify the information. To retrieve any table values, we have to use that select star from table name. The table name is a sellers. Select star from sellers. You are retrieving all the values. But I want the sellers, whose sellers I would like to print. So that means that whose rating is above 7 only. That means that you have to apply the condition that is nothing but select star from sellers where rating, the attribute name is a rating, where rating greater than 7. So that means that you are retrieving all the sellers information whose rating is above 7. Suppose whose rating is less than 7. So that means you are getting that whose ratings are below 7, those details that you are returning. Okay, whose rating is exactly 7. In such case, only two sellers that we have, Dustin and Parashiv. Okay, whose sellers ratings are greater than or equal to 7. That means that Dustin, Looper, Andy, Rusty, Horatio, Zorba. So like that we are retrieving the sellers details. So that means that you can identify that sellers whose rating is exactly 7 or less than, greater than, less than or equal, greater than or equal, not equal. And you can cross check that all the sellers information. Here I am representing all the sellers information selects are from table name. You can identify that the sellers information whose rating is not equal to 7. So you can identify that Dustin and Horatio only, Dustin, 22 Dustin and then 64 Horatio only having a rating 7 and the rest of the members are not having a 7. So that means that you have to be read on the query, select star from sellers where rating not equal to 7. So generally not equal is nothing but exclamation mark and then followed by equal and then 7. So you can get all the sellers information whose rating is not equivalent to 7. Not only that one, the another possibility of not equal or not acceptance is, so if you use the two angular sets parallelly at a time, that means that less than and greater than, that tells about that they are the, above 7 and below 7, not exactly 7. So that means that that's also a correct query to represent that whose rating is not equal to 7. Okay, so these are the possible ways to retrieve that sellers second query of sellers information whose rating is above 7. So move on to the third question. Find the names of sellers who have reserved a boat number 103. Find the names of sellers who have reserved a boat number 103. They are asking the names of sellers. If you cross check with the table values, who reserved a boat number, who reserved the names of sellers who reserved a boat 103. For example, the reservation that is done in the reservation table 103 relevant seller ID you had to be retrieved and that retrieve 22 related seller name you have to be print. Okay, so in this case, you had to be linked between the two tables, sellers table and the reserves table. You can use that with in operator, without in operator also, or with object reference or variable references related to the tables also. So that is also another possibility of writing a query. Now we will see the query related to this one. So that means that you are retrieving the sellers name, that is nothing but select S name from sellers. Whose S name that you are retrieving, whose SIDs are matched with the resource table, from the resource table whose BID is equivalent to 103. For example, project with the query. So here I am writing that select S name from sellers where SID in, whose SID is that you are retrieving. If it is exactly one SID, then you have to use that equal operator. If it is one or more, the more SIDs that you are retrieving from the resource table, from the resource table you are retrieving that boat ID is 103. That means that if you run this query, so that means that from the resource table you are retrieving the 22, 31, 74. Now you have to be retrieve the 22, 31, 74 related all the sellers information. So that means that the query had to write on that select S name from sellers where SID. Actually, when you are comparing with the operation, if it is exactly equal, then it is to be that record will be retrieved. So suppose if SID is equivalent, but here the inner query you are writing that retrieving that more than one values. In such case, you have to use that instead of equal, you have to use that in operator. In open the parenthesis and then you have to represent select SID from resource table who where BID is equivalent to 103. So that means that you are retrieving that whose sellers information, whose sellers names who are reserved the boat 103. So that is nothing but Dustin, Looper, Horatio. Suppose if the question is who have not reserved the boat 103. So that means that, so whose BIDs are equivalent to 103. So then you have to represent not equal. So I am retrieving that who are not reserved boat 103. And the remaining SIDs, whatever you have, that SIDs that I am going to be retrieving. Okay. So that is another possibility of writing a query. Okay. And another one, who have not reserved that boat number 103. So that means that, either you can use that not in for this case also. So that means that instead of in, here you can use that not in also. First you have to be identified that who reserved that boat 108 ID related sellers information, boat 108, 103 related seller ID is the information that you are retrieving, except that seller ID, remaining IDs from the sellers table. So that I am getting. So this is the actual query who are not resolved board 103. Like that. Or I am retrieving that all the sellers information except 103, the remaining sellers who have reserved the remaining information from the sellers table. Okay, so move on to the next figure. Third one, fourth one. Find the SIDs of sellers who have reserved a red board. Who reserved a red board? So if you see the structure of a table, the red board is reserved. The red board IDs are 102 we have, 104 we have. 102 and 104 related the question, the 102 and 104 related seller IDs that you are retrieving. So that means that you don't need to be worry about the sellers table. You have to link with them only the boards table and the reserves table. 102, 104 related. The seller IDs from the reserves table is 22 we have, 22 we have, and then 31 we have, 31 we have, 64 we have. So either 102 or 104. Okay. So we can write down that query in different possibilities. Here I am explaining all these possibilities. Select BID from boards where color equal to red. First I am identifying that from the boards table whose board IDs are having a color of red. So that means that from the boards table whose board color is a red, that board related BIDs I am retrieving. That BIDs related sellers SIDs from the reserves table. So that means that select SID from reserves table where BID in whose BIDs that you are retrieving, where the board color equally considered as a red from the boards table. Okay, so this is the one possibility of writing a query. So here if you cross check this one, so 22, 31, 64. To avoid that duplication of data, here you have to use that distinct keyword. So here you have to use that once the SID is repeating one or more number of times. To avoid that one, here you have to use that distinct. Okay, that means that so instead of repetition of 22 and 31, it is occurs only one time only. This is the one possibility of writing that query. Another possibility with referencing, here I am representing that select R dot SID. R stands for, what is the R and what is the B means. So R is nothing but reserves table, boards table is represented as a B. Select R dot SID from reserves table R, boards table B, where from the reserves table board ID is must and should be matched with boards table BID and boards table color must and should be red. So this is a referencing of a one table to another table. So here also we are getting the duplicate values. To avoid the duplication of more and more data, so here you have to use the distinct. So that means that whatever the data that is repeatedly occurred, that's also it can be removed. So this is the possibility of writing the identifying the board colors, board or sellers information who reserved a red board. Okay, so here no need to be sellers names, so sellers table environment, only reserves table SIDs, that is sufficient. For example, if the question is find the names of sellers who have reserved a red board, in such case now we have to be mapped to the sellers table. So now we have to be work on with the three different tables. First we have to be identify the sellers SIDs that we are retrieving. This SIDs related sellers names we have to be retrieved. So that is nothing but whatever the previous query that we have executed, so that query we are re-executing. So but instead of this one, select S name from sellers where SID in, so whose SID is that we are retrieving from the reserves table, SID is from the reserves table R, boards table B, where BID equal to. So already by the previous query that we executed, that query I would like to run. So here you can identify that Dustin, Luber, Horatio have reserved the board IDs, board with a color called red. So this is the one possibility. So with the referencing also, so we have the possibility of writing the same query with a query by query within the inner query also. So that's how I am explaining here. So here I am retrieving that sellers information, select SID from sellers table, whose SIDs that you are retrieving from the reserves table, BIDs you are retrieving, whose BIDs that you are retrieving from the boards table, whose board color is red. If the board color is red, the board color red related board ID is matched with the reserves table SIDs, reserves table SIDs matched with the sellers table SID. So then I would like to print that sellers name. So this is the one possibility. If it is a referencing, so then S dot S name from sellers S, reserves R, and a reserves table I am representing with R, board table I am representing with B, sellers table I am representing with S. Okay, so now as dot SID, seller's table SID master should be matched with the resource table SID, and resource table boot ID master should be matched with the boot table BID, and boot color master should be red. So this is the possibility of writing a who reserved a red boot. Okay, and the next one. For example, if you didn't use that distinct keyword, so then that means that one or more number of times the repetition may be a possibility. Okay, so that is the one possibility. And next one, find the colors of boots reserved by Luber. First, you have to identify that Luber reservation that we have done. So that means that find the colors of boots reserved by Luber. You have to be print that. Whatever the Luber SID that we have, the Luber SID related boot IDs, whatever you have, that boot related colors you have to be retrieving. So that means that, so previous question is related to the red color, and now this query is related to the reverse manner of the previous one, but not the red. So you have to be identified that what color that is reserved by the Luber. First, you have to be identified that from the sellers table, sellers name related, Luber related seller ID. So that is nothing, seller ID is nothing but 31. 31 related reservations that you have to be print. So 31 from the sellers table, 31 is nothing but Luber. You can cross check here. 31 related number of reservations what we have, 102 we have, 103 we have, 104 we have. 102, 103, 104 related boat colors are blue we have, red we have, and then green we have. 102, 103, 104. Sorry. That is nothing but red, green, red. Okay, two colors that we have. So that means that select SID from sellers table where SNAME equal to Luber. So whose SIDs are matched with, now you have to be extension of the reserves table. Select a BID from reserves table where SID, whose SID is related, where SID in. From the reserves table, you are retrieving that boots table whose SIDs are matched with the sellers table, and the sellers table related, the seller name is called Luber. So now we are retrieving that boat IDs are 102, 103, 104. So these related boat colors you have to be print. So that means that you have to be written one more inner query. Select color, cross check with the attribute name. Here the attribute name you have defined as a color. Color from boats table where BID in, and the remaining part of the query. So that means that whatever the boots table related from the boots table color we are printing, that color related boot IDs, that BID is matched with the resource table BID, that resource table BID matched with the sellers table SID, that sellers table SID is matched to seller name, must and should be Luber. So now the seller reserved, Luber reserved boots are red, green, red. Suppose if you have to be avoid the duplication of the data, then here you have to use that a distinct keyword. That distinct keyword tells you that the repetition of the data, whatever the data that is repetitively occurred, that will be eliminated. Only unique data that will be printed. So instead of say printing that red two times, if you use that distinct keyword, it will print only one time occurrence, one first occurrence of that data. Okay, so this is the one possibility of writing a query. So find the names of boats or colors reserved by Luber. So if you cross check with the remaining possibilities also, here I'm explaining all these possibilities once cross check. So either using inner queries or using equal operator also. And the next one, find the names of sellers who have reserved at least one boat. First, you have to be identified that who reserved, how many number of reservations that we have done for each and every user. First, we have to be find out the each seller ID related number of reservations that we have. So the number of reservations related to the each seller ID is nothing but from the resource table you can identify that 22 have reserved 4 boats, 31 have reserved 3 boats, and 64 have reserved 2 boats, and 74 have done only one reservation that we have. So that means that you have to be group according to the SIDs, that SID related BID count you have to be identified. So here SID is a one group. So if we group that SID, BIDs are varying. Now you have to be count these BIDs. So the query for that one is select, you have to be print the SID on the count of that BID from reserves table. From the reserves table. Now you have to be group by, you have to be apply the group by having clause. So for the SIDs, so now you have to be group the SIDs. That SID is related count you have to be identified. So 22 had done 4 reservations, 31 had done 3 reservations, and 21 64 had done 2 reservations, and then 74 had done 1 reservations. Now you have to be print that the seller's ID related the number of reservations that are at least 1 reservations. At least the names of sellers who have reserved at least 1 boat. First you have to be apply that group, and after that grouping you have to be print that only SIDs whose count he is. At least one boat means they may be reserved minimum 1 boat. That means that greater than 2 boats or greater than 1 boat, that is nothing but 2. If they have done 2 reservations, minimum 1 boat they have to be reserved. So greater than 1, anything is to be considered as a at least 1. So now you have to be identify that from the reserves table, you have to be identify the seller IDs. So according to the group by having clause, grouping by SIDs. But here we are applying the condition having whose count of BIDs are greater than or equal to 1. So actually we have written the query, but we are printing the count of BIDs. Actually you don't need of that count of BIDs. You have to be print that seller ID is reserved at least minimum 1 boat they have reserved. So already 22 we have, 31 we have, 64 we have, 74 we have. So that reservations that you have to be print. So okay, so that SID is related seller's name from the seller's table. So now if we run this fragment of code, cross check it. So here you can identify the distinct Luber for Russia. To avoid the duplication, here you have to use the distinct S name. The distinct tells about that whatever the duplicated data that is occurred, so that will be removed. So like that we can retrieve that who have reserved at least minimum 1 boat of reservations. First we had to be according to the seller ID, you had to be identify the count. That can be done by using group by only. After that grouping, you are cross checking that the number of reservations having count of that BIDs are greater than or equal. Actually in the printing cell, for understandability, we cross check that each SID related count of. But your question is, you have to be identify that who's having at least 1 board that has reserved. So that means that having count of BID greater than or equal to 1, you have to be cross checked. That is another case. And move on to the next one. Compute the increments for ratings of the persons who sail two different boats on the same day. First, you have to be identified that two different boats on the same day, is there any reservation that we have done or not. For example, if you consider that 102 and 103, in the reserves table 101 and 102, two boats are reserved on the same day. So that is nothing but 10th and 10th of 1998. So like that same, here you can identify that same day reservation, but two different sailors they have done. You have to be cross check that single sailor only. You have to be cross check with the single sailor of incrementation. For that sailor ID related, sailor rating or sailor rating, you have to be increment. So for that, you have to be use that actual rating and then followed by incrementing rating. For that, so here I would like to print that S dot rating. S is nothing but sales table. I would like to print S dot rating and incremented value. So here I am using that two updation. Either maybe use the 2, 3, 4, 5, anything is to be updated. Original rating, and after that improving the original rating plus 2 from the sales table as resource table R1, resource table R2, where seller ID is matched and should be matched with resource table SID. So here we have taken two reservation tables, references SSR R1 and R2. Why we have considered R1 and R2 is separately two different table means. Now you have to be map with your reservation table to same reservation table to cross check with two different boats have reserved on the same day or not. So that means that both the tables of BIDs must and should be different, and the number of reservation that I have done on the reservation table in both the table that must and should be same. So like that we can retrieve that sellers ratings and their incrementing of their sellers with the value 2. So previous rating is a 2, 7, now the rating is to be considered as a 9. So like that we can retrieve that whose sellers have different boats on the same day. Okay, and the next one, find the ages of sellers whose name begin and end with B and has at least three characters. This type of queries are related to the pattern matching related. So that means that you have to be use that like keyword, whether as name or ename or employee names or sales names or student names, whose name starting with a particular character, ending with a particular character, that having exactly these number of characters or any position of characters. So that can be done by using a pattern matching question, pattern matching related. So here you are trying to be print that whose sales name begins and ends with a B and has at least three sellers. For example, if I written the query is select S name from sellers where S name like, here you had to use that instead of equal operator, here you had to use that like, where the S name starts with, here they are asking that whose name starts with B only and ends with B and has exactly three characters. First we cross check with starting with B, whose name starts with B. So here you had to use that B and then percentage. That means that so B is a character that is starting, after that B any number of characters. Any number of characters we represent with a percentage. That means that whose name starting with B. So that is nothing. Brutus we have, Bob we have. Every query must and should be ended with a semicolon. Here we have not represent that semicolon. That is an error. Whose name ends with B, starting with B. Suppose if it is an ends with B, so any number of characters B must and should be the last question, last position. So in such case Bob we have. Suppose if you are going to be retrieving that whose names in any positions of their names, percentage B, percentage any number of characters B followed by any number of characters. So in such case you can retrieve that Brutus, Luber, Jorba, Bob. In the Brutus, B may be the first character. In the Luber, B may be the second, third character or fourth character. In Jorba, the B may be a fourth character, and Bob B may be the first character. So like that. So that means that, so this question tells you about that, find the names of sellers whose name starting with B, ending with B, or any position of B, exactly three ways. In such case, you have to use that starting with B, okay, ending with B. Suppose if it is exactly three characters. If you are stressing that exactly three characters, two characters are already fixed, third character may be in between of them. So in such case, you have to use that underscore. Starting with B, ending with B. The middle position may be whatever it may be the character. Such type of sales if they have any. So then their names will be printed. There is nothing of Bob, B or B. So the middle position may be any positions. Three characters that we are retrieving. Okay. So this is the one possibility. Next. Find the names of sellers who have reserved a red boat or a green boat. When you are trying to be retrieving the values of red boat and green boat, so here you can identify that either red boat or green boat or red boat and green boat, only red boat, not a green boat. So in such case, you have to use that Venn diagram related information. Both are valid cases, only one valid case or vice versa cases, representations. In such case, here we have to use that union and intersect minus. These are the operators that we have to use. Okay, so now we'll cross check that who have reserved a red boat or a green boat. So red boat and a green boat, red boat or a green boat. So red boat related SID, BIDs are 102 and 104. Green boat is 103. So that means you have to be cross check that 102, 103, 104 related sellers IDs and the sellers name you have to be printed. Okay, in such case, if both red boat and a green boat or red boat or green boat, in such case you have to be used that red or green, or means here you have to use that union, and means you have to use that intersect. Such type of queries here you can use that R is represented as a union operator and is represented with the intersection operator. First you have to be into the red boat related seller IDs and green boat related seller IDs. Both these SIDs related sellers names you have to be print. So here I am applying that both red boat or a green boat. So here cross check that. Both red boat or green boat that are reserved by the distinct Luber or Asher. Suppose if it is a both red boat and green boat, in such case here you have to, instead of union, here you have to use that the keyword called intersect. You have to use that connection is nothing, intersect. That means that once the intersect is to be done, so both the boats reserved by this sellers are distinct and Luber. So once if we cross check with both the red boat and green boat reserved is 102, 103, 104. Either 102, 103 or 103, 104. Like that. 102, 103 related 22 we have. 31 we have. Okay. 64 had reserved 102, but they have not reserved the 103. So this is not a valid. 74 have reserved 103, but 74 have not reserved 102 or 104. So that means that only 22, 31. 22 and 31 related seller IDs names are Dustin and then Looper. So that means that you are getting the Dustin and the Looper. So that's the way of writing that both red board or green board. That is nothing but union and intersect. Who reserved a red board, not a green board? In such case, you have to be use that minus operator. So that's also here I'm explaining. Find the names of sellers who have reserved a red board but not a green board. First, you have to be identified that green board who reserved. From the green board, who reserved a green board seller IDs that are eliminated from the who reserved the boards called red color. So that means that first you have to be identified that who reserved a red board, that a red board related seller IDs are removed who reserved a board called green. So for that, so here we can write down that not equal. So here select distinct S name from sellers VIDs in the boards table whose color equal to red. The red related boat IDs related SIDs from the reserves table. So that is union with whose color equal to red and they are not to be green. Means like that. So that is nothing 22, 31, 64. So this is the way of writing a query. And next one is find all the seller IDs from the sellers who are having a rating of 10 or have reserved a board 104. They may be a rating of 10 or they may be reserved a board number 4. First we can identify that from the reserves table whose board IDs are equivalent to 104. They may be reserved with a board number 104 or whose rating is of 10. Whose rating of 10, that is the exact reason. From the sellers table, you are retrieving that whose rating ID is 10. So then those two sets related, commonly related SIDs, whatever we have, that values that we are retrieving. Select SID from reserves table where BID equivalent 104 union. Select SID from sellers table where rating equal to 10. They may be reserved 104 board or they may be a rating of 10. So this is the way of writing that. This is the way of writing that who reserved a board 104 and parallelly who are having a rating of 10. So this is the possibility of writing a query. And move on to the next one. Find the names of sellers who have not reserved a red board. They have not reserved a red board, but they may be reserved some another board. First we have to identify that board red color related board IDs. From the board table, whose board IDs are matched with color called red. So that BIDs are, I don't want. The remaining BIDs related SIDs and SIDs related S names. That means that select S name from the LS table where SID in. Select SID from the reserves table where BID not in. So that means that BID one red color related board IDs whatever, that is to be eliminated and the rest of the members we are going to be retrieving. So here we come cross check it. Distinct Looper Horatio. To avoid the duplication of the data, here you have to use the distinct keyword. Okay, so this is the who reserved a red board and not a green board. So not only that one, we can use that another format of also. We have reserved a red board and we have not reserved a green board. This is the one way of writing a query. And move on to the next one. Find the names of sellers whose rating is better than some seller called Horatio. Every seller called. In such case, first you have to identify that Horatio rating. To know that Horatio rating, select a rating from table name where the seller name must and should be Horatio. First, you have to identify that rating of his sellers called Horatio. That rating is matched with each and every rating of individual records available in the sellers table. In such case, better than some seller or better than every. So here you can project the both the queries of 15 and 16. Better than some seller or better than every seller. Some seller or every seller. Some seller means greater than any. Every means greater than all. So that means that every record that may be greater than, then those records we are going to be printing. If it is each and every record that is matched, then those records, that is nothing greater than any or greater than all. So it's the same query, so that will print. First it can identify that seller's rating, whose rating is above 7. The seller ID, Parashar related seller ratings are 7, and the 7 compared with the remaining seller's information. Here you can identify that Parashar ratings are 7 is one seller rating and 9 is another one. So compare with the 7, 9 is better, but compare with 9, 7 is not good. So in such case we are going to be retrieving this information, better than some seller or better than every seller. So instead of greater than any, here you have to use it greater than all also. So that means that Parashars are two types of Parashars that we have. So each and every seller Parashar that will be matched with any one of them. If we compare with every seller called, in such case Parashar concept, two Parashars that we have. So when we compare with the ninth Parashar, Luber and Andy is not good. So that means that these two records are to be eliminated and the rest of the records are to be retrieved. These are the possibilities of writing a query. Okay, so yeah.